The freestyle wrestling reached the women's sub-55 kilo medal stage. The first bronze match saw Tatiana Lazareva from Ukraine fight Colombia's Jacqueline Rentera. And what a tight contest it was. They'd each taken a round, so this was the decider. And late on, Rentera secured the crucial advantage. And this is a sport in which even the celebrations can be a little rough. The second bronze medal match was fought out by Azerbaijan's Yulia Ratkovich and the Russian Valeria Zobolova. It was a bruising affair in which Ratkovich, who was born in Belarus but represents Azerbaijan, came out on top. And she was an Olympic bronze medalist. And so to the final, in which Canada's Tonya Verbeek faced the daunting task of fighting Saori Yoshida, double Olympic and 9-times world champion. Yoshida was Japan's flag bearer at the opening ceremony and had never lost a bout at the Olympics. She won the first round convincingly. Verbeek had won silver and bronze at Olympic Games in the past, but her chances of adding gold were becoming increasingly slim as the contest went on. And victory for Yoshida was duly confirmed. She was a 3-time Olympic champion. Japanese women had won 3 of the 4 freestyle wrestling gold medals available at the 2012 Games. The Japanese supporters were in the mood to celebrate. Yoshida collected gold again. Verbeek's third Olympic medal was silver, and Rentera and Ratkovich both took bronze.
The medal that I just got here at London 2012 is the best and the biggest medal for me because I had a very hard process and hard training before I came here through the 8th in 2004 and Beijing 2008.
Why are Japanese women so good at wrestling?
When they are kids, they start training very, very hard without any break. That's why we are so strong.
Oh, it feels great, really. Like, I came here to compete the best I could, and, you know, ultimately I felt like I did that. And that's all you can do when you're an athlete, right? It's you try to do your best, and I had to push through some matches today, so I was very happy with myself, how I, you know, kept persisting, and that's typically my attitude, and I go out and I fight hard, and so I really enjoyed today, to be honest with you. It's no matter what the result, I still had a wonderful time. She's really strong, and we battled it out time and time again, and you know, she's got this really good strategy and tactics, and you know, I feel that she's an awesome wrestler, and you know, it is what it is, and I'm happy that I could be supporting and just representing Canada, representing women's wrestling. Awesome crowd here for women's wrestling. Wow.
I'm elated. This is fantastic. I've worked so, so hard for this. And I always knew that I had the capabilities to get in first place, and that's what I fought for during the whole thing. And at least I have my second bronze medal. This is an absolutely fantastic moment. I've worked so, so hard in my life, and right now I have to thank God for everything he's done for me. This is his as well, as much as it is mine.
Feliz, 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 feliz. Lo adoro y la gloria y la honra en este momento es para él.
What did your mum say to you?
She's over the moon. She loves me. She supported me all these years, her and my family and friends. And I have the best mother on earth. She's absolutely fantastic. I have a gift from God in my mom. It's absolutely amazing. And she's with me every day. She supports me. She gives me advice every day. And I have the best mother on earth. It's absolutely fantastic.
The women's freestyle wrestling reached the sub-72 kilo medal stage. And in the first of the two bronze matches, Kazakhstan's Guzel Manyarova fought Wang Xiao of China, who'd won gold in Beijing 4 years ago at the age of just 20. It was close. They'd won a round each, and it was all square in the third. This would clinch it. Manyarova had to register a score or lose. She forced Wang off the mat, and at the age of 34, was an Olympic medalist. In the second bronze match, Spain's 35-year-old Maida Under fought Vasilisa Mazaliuk of Belarus. Under had won the first round and would win the fight if she held on from this position. Her experience shone through. Another veteran had a medal. Under had the bronze. And so to the gold medal match, where Russia's 21-year-old Natalia Vorobieva fought the silver medalist from Beijing, Stanka Zlatova-Hristova. The Bulgarian is a five-time world champion. Zlatva Hristova had won the first round, but was then caught out by Vorobieva, who was able to pin her and win the bout. Vorobieva had pulled off the surprise. Zlatva Hristova was devastated. She had to settle for silver, defeated by a youngster in the final, as she had been 4 years ago. It was the Russian who was the Olympic champion. So the last women's freestyle gold to be awarded went to Vorobieva, silver went to Zlatva Hristova, and the bronze medals to Manurova and Under.
I'm very happy, extremely happy. Finally, I got the reward I've been working for the last 10 years. It's probably the ultimate reward you can get. There was no tactics, there was no secret. As my coaches told me, you already have silver, so you don't really have anything to lose. So I went as an ultimate fight, just for the fight of it.
Выходила сражаться, наверное, вот как на последний бой действительно.
Any medal is a huge happiness because it takes 4, sometimes 6 years to get the medal, hard work, and it's not like it's a championship which happens every year. It only happens once every 4 years. So I'm happy that I made the people who believed in me happy, and I'm happy that I got the medal. The tactic is fight and win. That's basically what it is. And the one who wishes he wants more wins, because some technical errors, some physical immaterial errors, they're all covered by the big wish to win.
I was fifth in Pekin. I really have been dreaming for this for 4 years.
It looked as if there was quite a lot of support. How much did the support help today?
I want to offer it to them because they've been helping me for 4 years, and that's the best thing ever.
The women's 10-meter platform final at the Aquatic Center. 12 divers looking to impress on their 5 dives. China's Chen Ralin was the defending Olympic champion. In London, she performed brilliantly once again. Her arm stand back somersault with 1.5 twists impressed the judges, keeping her on top of the leaderboard. Australia's Melissa Wu was second going into the third round. However, a miss on her back 3.5 somersault tuck left her off the podium. Malaysia's Pamdela Lepang struggled with early inconsistent dives. However, she used her final dive to earn the bronze by a point. 7 judges scored diving with the highest and lowest scores thrown out and then multiplied by the degree of difficulty. 16-year-old Brittany Broben used one of the most difficult dives to secure the silver. The Australian's back 2.5 somersault with 1.5 twists scored 81 points. China's Chen Ralin won the competition by 56 points on her final dive. The Chinese diver led after every round, earning her second consecutive Olympic gold on platform. Chen won her first Olympic gold at 15 years old in Beijing. In London, she defends her Olympic title with 422 points. Australia's Brittany Broben earned silver and Malaysia's Pamdela Lepang the bronze in the women's 10-meter platform.
I feel very relaxed. It seems like it's not Olympic, very high pressure. I feel very relaxed. I feel very proud to add more gold medal for the Chinese team.
Do you have any advice for your Chinese teammate Hu?
She's very young, and this is the first time she attends the Olympics, so I think she still has a lot of chance to do this. And she should maybe more grow up and then more stable, and then I believe she will be the very nice girl as well.
What are your plans for Rio 2016?
Right now, I'm not very sure, but yeah, I would like to be there.
Unbelievable. It's amazing. It's a dream come true. I never thought it would happen, and I was so nervous on my last dive, but I couldn't be happier. I don't know. I was just so nervous. There was a point between second and 10th, so it's it was so close, and I didn't want to let all my hard work go to waste. I had to do it, so yeah.
Today dives, I think very good except for the first and third dive. I'm very proud and honored to win a medal for my country.
Volleyball's semi-final stage, Brazil and Japan battling for a place in the gold medal game against the United States. The reigning champions from South America finally hitting form against a Japanese team aiming for their first final appearance since the Montreal Games in 1976. It was a match-up of contrasting styles. Powerful Brazil against a side better known for their defence. But in a brilliantly contested first set, the two teams threw everything at each other. With so much at stake, every point mattered, ensuring some memorable rallies. This one would go the way of Brazil and broke the first set open. They would win it by 25 points to 18. After a slow start to London 2012, a dramatic quarter-final win against Russia had woken Brazil up. They saved 6 match points in their five-set success, and the confidence gained from that was on show in the second set. Renowned for their power, they spiked their way through it, taking it by 10 points. As the game had gone on, Brazil had got better, and they secured a rematch of the 2008 gold medal game against the USA, impressively and in straight sets. Japan's second best, but they'll now take on Korea for bronze.
The Netherlands didn't just clinch a place in the final of the men's hockey, they crushed Great Britain in the semi-final in extraordinary style. The Netherlands only earned 4 penalty corners in the match, they scored from 3 of them. Roderick Voistoff scored the first in the 9th minute. He then added a second from open play. Ashley Jackson pulled a goal back for Great Britain to make it 2-1, but in truth that was the last time the home team were truly in the match. Within 4 minutes, Mink van der Weerden made it 3-1. He'd scored at least once from a penalty corner in every match the Netherlands had played. And Billy Bakker made it 4-1 before half-time. Great Britain knew their chances of reaching the final had vanished. The Netherlands scored 4 times in 6.5 minutes in the second half. That goal by Billy Bakker made it 8-1. It was his third of the match. And Voistoff scored his third to make it 9-1. Robert Moore scored a late consolation goal for Great Britain, but the Netherlands had sent out an obvious message about their strengths and ruthlessness. They will play Germany in the final. Great Britain will face Australia in the bronze medal match. The result, the Netherlands 9, Great Britain 2.
The USA and Spain contested the gold medal in women's water polo. The USA had a bronze and 2 silvers from the past 3 Olympic Games. They were on a mission for gold and got it, in control for most of the match. But it was Spain who settled more quickly. It took over 3 minutes for the opening goal, which came from captain Jennifer Perea. The USA levelled towards the end of the quarter. They took hold of the second period and didn't let go throughout the rest of the game. Maggie Steffens with a hat-trick to put them at 5-2 going into half-time. Plenty for Spain to think about. But by now, the USA were firmly in control. They had a highly experienced side, including Brenda Villa, playing in her 4th Olympic Games. Spain's aim was poor throughout, straight into the arms of Betsy Armstrong here. A last throw of the dice for Spain, but they had too much ground to make up. After 4 attempts in medal matches, the USA finally had an Olympic gold medal. Spain, playing in their first Olympic Games, had to settle for silver.
It has been worth it. There's no words to express what I'm feeling, but to be able to go through with this group of girls again from last 4 years ago, and to be with youngsters like Maggie and you, coach, it means a lot to me, for our sport, for our country. So I'm just proud today.
What does it mean to family and friends?
I think to them it's probably like Brenda's gonna have her fairy tale. They're gonna be so happy for me. My mom before the games, like, whatever happens, you have to be happy today. Just the end of a journey, but I got my fairy tale ending, so I'm happy regardless. So it's a great day today.
Tell me about a couple of players. First of all, Maggie Steffens.
Oh my God, she's a phenomenal player. I mean, you would never know that she's 19 years old, but really I think our anchor of our team is Betsy Armstrong. She today, I don't think anybody wanted to shoot on her, and we just feed off her. She makes these incredible saves, and that gives us, you know, motivated to go on offense. But Maggie today, I mean, she plays like a veteran. I'm so excited to watch her play for the next 10 years.
We're very happy, obviously, we wish that the match could have gone better, but we're very happy. This is three big in the middle, so we're very happy.
Have you enjoyed your Olympic experience?
Yeah, we're very happy. It's our first time in the Games. We've managed to go all the way to the final. So we enjoyed the final a bit less than the other games, but to reach the final first ever, first time, fantastic.
How proud are you of your teammates?
Yeah, obviously, I'm very, very proud. It's a very young team, but to be able to reach the final in our first games, I'm extremely proud of the team.
The 12,000-seater basketball arena was crackling with anticipation for the second semi-final of the women's handball between Spain and Montenegro. Montenegro were the first country to reach the last four of the handball in their maiden Olympics. Their last-minute victory over France was the biggest upset of the tournament so far. It was Spain's first appearance in an Olympic semi-final. Their previous best was sixth place. The opening exchanges were fast and furious. Five goals in the first 5 minutes. But there was also subtlety too. How about this for a penalty? In a tight first half, the lead seesawed back and forth, but at the break, the two teams were locked at 13 all. Who would be celebrating at the end? The game of cat and mouse continued in the second half, and at the midway point, there was still nothing between them. But in the closing stages, Montenegro opened up a four-point lead and their fans dared to dream. At the final whistle, they weren't dreaming but screaming as Montenegro held on to complete an extraordinary victory. This tiny country through to the final in their first ever Olympic Games. Heartbreak for Spain. Montenegro progressed to the final, where they'll play Norway. Taekwondo, the climax of the women's under 57 kilogram category. The first bronze medal match between Mayu Hamada from Japan and Marlene Hanwa from France. It was a tight battle that the French woman won. Two bronze medals are given out in each category of taekwondo. This was the second. Suvi Mikkonen of Finland and the number one seed Tseng Li Cheng battled it out. The fighter from Chinese Taipei was too strong from the off. She won comfortably. So to the final. Great Britain's Jade Jones and second seed Hu Yuzhu were going for gold. The Chinese is the world champion. She beat Jones in the final. Could the British fighter come out on top this time? The home crowd tried to lift Jones, and she scored the first point. She built up a lead, but the Chinese fighter came back strongly. Jones, though, hung on for victory. The crowd took the roof off. So it was gold for Jade Jones of Great Britain, silver to Hu Yuzhu of China, and bronze to Marlene Hanwha of France and Tseng Li Cheng of Chinese Taipei.
I still don't believe it now. I think I need to wake up and realise, but it's just amazing, and the crowd's been amazing. I've trained so hard and I've dreamt about it for ages, like not sleeping and just everything. So for it to actually be real is just unbelievable.
And this is a story that happened a long time ago. Can you just explain some of the struggles and everything that you've come through to be here?
My granddad used to have to drive me to Manchester like four times a week, drive me to Cardiff, drive me to everywhere, and so just training 6 times a week with Paul, getting up at everything, it's just finally paid off, and it's just amazing that it has.
How much has this support here meant to you and all the support back home?
It's crazy, I can't even explain. Like, it's been overwhelming, all the support. I tried to imagine it, like what it would be like, but when I came out, it's just overwhelming. I couldn't imagine it at all.
Did that make a big difference?
Yeah, definitely. Every time I came out, as soon as I heard the crowd, I was like, right, I'm going for it.
I think my energy wasn't good, especially the second and the third half. I feel so tired at times. I can't play as what I'm planning to do. All my opponents gave me so much experience, and I see what's the weak point of my actions, and I will go back home to take these positive things and to do better.
Taekwondo, the final matches of the men's under 68 kilogram category. The opening bronze medal contest. Brazilian Diogo Silva in the blue protectors against Terence Jennings from the United States. Silva was the number six seed, but it was the unseeded Jennings who took an early lead with a spinning head kick. The American went on to win, 8 points to 5. The second bronze medal match was between Great Britain's Martin Stamper and Rahullah Nikpar from Afghanistan. Stamper knew he could count on noisy support from the home crowd. Nikpar is an Afghan hero. His bronze in Beijing was his country's first ever Olympic medal. The British fighter was desperate to win at his home Olympic Games, but it was Nikpar who came out on top. The battle for the gold medal was between the two top seeds, Servet Tazagel from Turkey and Mohamed Bagheri from Iran. It was very close, but it would be the Turks' day. It was his Iranian opponent who took the lead. Tazagel, who won a bronze medal in Beijing, levelled the scores. And that's how the match went. When one fighter scored, the other countered. But it was Tazagel who came away with a precious gold medal. So it was gold to Servet Tazagel of Turkey, silver to Mohamed Bagheri of Iran, and bronze to Rahullah Nikpar from Afghanistan and Terence Jennings from the United States.
Çok mutluyum. Tabii son yıllara bakınca.
I'm very happy. Looking back, everyone expected it of me, and because I've achieved, and I'm very happy because I have achieved my goal.
Dünya, ardından 2012 Olimpiyat şampiyonluğu hedefliyordum ve buna başardığım için çok mutluyum.
Obviously, I'm not happy. I've been training for 4 years in order to get gold, but unfortunately, I couldn't get gold. So as a result, I'm happy that I don't go home with empty hands.
این اتفاق نیفتاد و خدا رو شکر می‌کنم که دست خالی به میان از اون بر نمیاد.
It's amazing. It's a tough, long day. I mean, didn't start off like I wanted, but I'm glad I could still hold on and grasp a medal. Just add another one to the count for USA.
What have you thought of the support and the crowd? What's it been like being in here?
Outstanding. I mean, I'm not in my home country. I feel like I'm at home. All the USA flags, all the cheers when I walk out. Everyone supporting, everyone saying my name. I mean, it's impossible to explain. I feel like I'm right at home here.
I'm very happy because I can get this is the second time I get the bronze medal, Olympic Games. I'm very happy. This medal is very important for my country, for all country, but for my country is very important. I love Afghanistan, I love Korea. Thank you.
North Greenwich Arena, semifinal, France and Russia. France proved to be the better team and won. France started the game off strongly. Emily Gomez scored as France recorded the match's first 8 points. Russia fought off nerves and began to make its shots, but France had a lead after the first quarter. France moved the ball effectively. Edwards Larson Wade led France with 11 first half points. But Russia kept the score close, and they trailed by 7 at halftime. Little separated these teams in the third quarter. Becky Hammon with his three-point effort, and that cut into the France lead. But France worked to get the ball close to the basket, and when they did, Sandrine Gruda took advantage. Late in the third quarter, France captain Céline Dumerc scored just as the buzzer sounded. It was a three-point effort, and France headed to the fourth quarter with an eight-point lead and plenty of momentum. France dominated the last 10 minutes. They also got plenty of bounces to go their way. Off a missed Russian shot, Gruda had an open path to the Russian basket, and France had its biggest lead. France began to attack the basket with confidence and were rewarded as Endine Miem scored. Moments later, the lead was 20 on this basket from Emmeline Dongu. And in the dying seconds, Dumerc scored on a three-point shot. And the French basketball team, in only their second Olympic Games, advanced to the gold medal match. They will face the U.S. Russia will play Australia for bronze.
Wembley was the setting for the gold medal match in the women's football. Defending champions United States played Japan in a repeat of last year's World Cup final. The Americans in blue have won four out of the last five Olympic titles, and they struck first after just 8 minutes. A smart turn and cross from Alex Morgan was met by Carly Lloyd. The midfielder, who scored in the final in Beijing, just beating teammate Abby Wambach to the punch. Japan came storming back, and only excellent defence from the United States prevented an equaliser. Captain Chrissy Rampone leading by example. Moments later, Yuki Agimi's header was tipped onto the crossbar by Hope Solo. And in the 26th minute, the world champions should have had a penalty, a handball. But Japan were fortunate not to concede another goal when Azusa Iwashimizu headed onto her own post. The Americans' goal led a charm life when Aya Mayana hit the frame of the goal again for Japan. Trailing 1-0 at halftime, Japan needed a quick response, but in the 54th minute, it was American Carly Lloyd who scored a wonderful individual goal. Her second of the game and fourth of the tournament. But Japan wouldn't go down without a fight. And after a goal-mouth scramble, Ogimi got them back in the game. The world champions threw everything at the Americans in search of the equaliser. Substitute Mana Inwanboshi missed a gilt-edged chance near the end, Hope Solo saving the day. The United States hung on to win the gold medal and their third Olympic title in a row. The attendance at Wembley, just over 80,000, an Olympic record for a women's football match. The dominance of the United States in women's football continues. They won the gold and are Olympic champions for the fifth time. Japan have to settle for the silver medal, and Canada claimed the bronze.
I thought we were gonna go all the way, and it never goes the way you want it to go. But we won six games straight, and we usually, lose in group play, or we came back with an amazing game against Canada in the semifinal, and things actually went our way, the way we predicted them to go.
Well, you had a great game, and you had to have a great game, because Japan created a lot of chances, didn't they?
Yeah, you can't win a major tournament without some good goalkeeping, and you can see the Japanese goalkeeper, she did a lot of work as well tonight, so it was a team effort, and I'm just proud. I'm proud to contribute, finally.
I think I was in a little bit of shock in 2008 that I scored such a big goal. I think right now in my career, I'm at a place where I feel that I played really well and consistent this whole entire tournament. And today, I was stepping up, and I was leading, and I was trying to be the person to make the difference.
And just finally, a word about Japan. There was a lot of talk about revenge in the run-up to this game, but I think at the end, the word most people would use is respect.
We have a tremendous amount of respect for them. You know, they're a great team, and they had some chances and were unlucky on a few. Hope had some amazing saves, kept us in the game, and we scored more goals than they, and we were the better side.
When the game ended, I was sad, like pain, but now, like, we did well and we did everything, so it's okay.
What about the crowd? 80,000 people, the biggest ever for an Olympic women's match.
That's amazing. That is a big because USA is very great, like super team, so it's nice.
And what memories will you take home with you from the Olympics?
That was amazing experience, so I'm proud of myself, but mostly I'm proud of my teammates.
The final of the men's triple jump, the favourite Christian Taylor of the United States, the world champion. 12 finalists, each with three initial jumps before the field is reduced to 8 competitors. Taylor started with 2 fouls, leaving him in danger of going out. He did go through with his 3rd attempt, which meant he had 3 more jumps. With his 4th try, he produced his best effort of the season to earn him the gold medal, a jump of 17 metres, 81 centimetres. The silver was to go to his USA teammate, Will Clay. This was his 2nd medal of London 2012 after getting a bronze in the long jump. No athlete had won medals in both events in the Olympic Games in the last 76 years. Fabrizio Donato of Italy had led early on and improved steadily with each jump, but the European champion eventually had to settle for bronze. Levan Sands from the Bahamas started as a medal contender. He won bronze in Beijing, but this time his challenge ended when he was forced to retire hurt when he was in 5th place. Contrasting emotions for Christian Taylor, who took the gold medal, silver also going to the USA, with Italy getting the bronze. The victory ceremony for the men's triple jump. It's 20 years since the United States took gold and silver in this event. Christian Taylor winning the gold medal, teammate Will Clay getting silver. And Fabrizio Donato, the bronze, Italy's first medal in the event since 1968.
It's such a blessing to share this moment with my family from the States, my family from Barbados. I'm just so honored, so blessed. I have to thank my church. I have to thank my coach, Raina Ryder, even his wife, for allowing him to come out day in and day out and spend all the hours that he does with us. I'm just so blessed.
What was going through your mind during competition?
At the beginning, I was a little anxious. I was very excited. I came here, the goal was to take Jonathan Edwards' mark, and so I had that in mind, and I was really just letting loose. But after I fouled 2, I knew I needed to just chill out a little bit and get to the finals. And so just blessing after blessing, and I'm just so honored to be Olympic champ now.
It's awesome. You know, I wish I had one more event. Maybe I would have got the gold. Bronze, silver, gold, but you know, I'm thankful for, you know, leaving here with 2 medals. You know, a lot of people haven't even left with 1, so you know, it's a blessing for me to even be here, let alone leave with medals, and I'm thankful. I thank God for it.
How deep did you have to dig to get that 2nd medal?
I had to dig just as deep as I did for the long jump. You know, the triple jump is my event, you know, that's my bread and butter. And I barely made it to the finals, but you know, I think God had a plan for me in getting into the finals, and I left with a medal, so I can't complain. You know, me and Christian went 1-2, so I couldn't ask for anything better than that.
Una carriera intera, questa è la mia 4ª Olimpiade.
It's a whole career, I'm working for it. It's my 4th Olympic game, and finally the dream came true.
Finalmente si è realizzato un sogno. Tantissimo lavoro, tantissimo.
This result is double because all the work, all the passion he put in all his years of training eventually came with a great result this tonight. So he said that he does the triple jump with love.
Of the 8 men in the 200 meters final, none was carrying higher or more justified expectations than Usain Bolt. In the lead-up to London 2012, the great Jamaican had spoken of his wish to become a legend at these games. This was the race that could make it happen, after 3 world records and 4 gold medals from 4 Olympic finals in his career so far. A poor start seemed the only thing that could have given the other runners a chance. So when Bolt flew out of the blocks and headed for the straight, clearly in front, it was simply a question of who would fill the placings and whether Bolt's own world record was safe. In the end, he appeared to ease up, crossing the line in 19.32 seconds, leaving the world guessing as to how low he could have gone by maintaining full speed. The winner's teammate and friend, Johan Blake, was a clear 2nd, with Warren Weir making it 1-2-3 for Jamaica by finishing 3rd. the first time the Caribbean nation has swept an Olympic event. Usain Bolt became the fifth person to win five Olympic athletics titles, and the only one ever to do it before turning 26. He became the first to win four titles in the 100 and 200 meter sprints. And once again, he showed the world that more than anyone in history, he makes running very, very fast look very, very easy. And so to the crowning of the latest legend of the track, Jamaica's Usain Bolt becoming the only man ever to successfully defend the Olympic 200 meters title. In second place, the silver medalist in both the sprints, Johan Blake, the first man since Frankie Fredericks in 1996 to do so. And Warren Weir taking the bronze, making it an all-Jamaican podium in the men's 200 meters.
There's not words. There's not words to explain. This is what I came here for, to show the world that I am the best. I'm a legend now. I am the greatest athlete there ever is. And I put myself in the Herb McKinley, Arda Wint, Michael Johnson, all these great athletes. So for me, it's an honor to be in that door.
What's it taken?
Hard work. The 200 was pretty much harder than I expected. I came off that corner, I could feel the pressure on my body, but all I had to do was focus, stay flat, and just drive home, and I did just that.
You've achieved so much. What's left for you to achieve now?
Right now, I don't know. This is what I came here to do, to make myself a legend. I've done that. So right now, 4x1s, we're going to go out there, we're going to do our best. That's just, for me, that's just fun. I'm just going to run my best, but I've become a legend.
What does it mean to be part of such a special night for Jamaica?
It's wonderful. This is the greatest spin country. We have shown the world that we can be the best, and that's what we did.
Well, you know, it has been great. Give God thanks, my coach Glenn Mills, of course, my Terpa Sean Kecker, Usain Bolt. Of course, you know, it has been good. Double silver medalist, my first Olympics. I can't complain. I have to give God thanks.
And how special was that race for Jamaica?
It was special. You know, all our guys that came 1, 2, 3 from Racers Track Club. Coach Mills has been working fine, and this is good for Jamaica.
First, I must say, to God be the glory. Coach Mills, Sean Keckle, Mummy, my fiance, everyone that's been around me, thank you very much. It's a tremendous feeling to know that I came out here and did my country very well. We got the 1, 2, 3. Jamaica, it's a wonderful 50.
How emotional is this for you as a man so young?
Words can't express how I feel right now. I guess I'll have to do an interview another time when I catch myself and tell you. But for now, and as long as I can remember, can't express myself. It's a wonderful feeling. I love London.
One of the highlights of the Olympic Games, the final of the men's 800 metres. The hot favourite David Rudisha of Kenya aiming to smash his own world record. Rudisha beaten only once in more than 2 years. By this man, Mohamed Aman from Ethiopia, just 18 years of age. Two Kenyans in the field, the USA also with two runners. A race packed with young talent. Rudisha in lane four likes to run from the front, and that's what happened. His target to complete the first lap in 50 seconds, and he was on schedule. Twice this summer he'd gone close to toppling his record, and this time he was to beat it. Rudisha was inspired to take up athletics after his father showed him the Olympic medal he won in 1968. Daniel Rudisha was part of the Kenyan team that won silver in the relay in Mexico. No room for family sentiment from the opposition in an Olympic final, but it was clear from a long way out that the rest of the field were fighting for silver and bronze. This race was so fast that all eight finalists set personal best or seasonal best times. Rudisha was to beat the world record, the greatest 800 metres performance in history on the biggest stage of all. Nigel Amos of Botswana won the battle for second place, with another Kenyan runner, Timothy Kitten, third. This was Botswana's first medal at any Olympic Games. But the glory belonged to David Rudisha with a fantastic display of middle distance running, one of the big stars of London 2012. And so to the victory ceremony for the men's 800 metres, David Rudisha making Olympic history with a new world record. A special occasion too for Botswana, their first Olympic medal from Nigel Amos. Bronze for Timothy Kitten, making two Kenyan athletes on the podium.
This is very special to me today.
to win here the gold medal and to break the world record is something unbelievable. I couldn't even believe that I have done it.
And how hard were you targeting that world record?
I knew I was in good shape, and I knew I was going to break the world record this year. But to do it here is special, and I was just expecting for good weather, and that is what I got today.
How memorable will these Olympic Games be for you?
I think this is something I'll never forget in my life.
And how hard have you had to work for it?
Yeah, I've trained a lot this year. I've been working hard with my coach. We have been doing a lot of workout without sleeping, all the time thinking about fast races and championship tactics. And now I'm happy that all is through.
I've been training for 6 months for the games.
And what were your feelings when you crossed the line?
Yeah, I was dead. I was really tired.
And we saw how much it took out of you. How are you?
Well, it has worked for me. I've done a good time, bringing the first ever Olympic medal to my country. Wow, so happy.
What do you think family and friends back home in Botswana will think of what you've done here?
Yeah, I'd like to thank all the people from Botswana, my family, for the support they gave for me to have managed to achieve so hard.
And how much more is there to come from your career now?
Yeah, looking forward to take the world record.
Very happy to have met to be a bronze medalist in the Olympics. Yeah, this great achievement.
And what did it mean to be part of the fastest race in history?
Yeah, it was good. I was very good. David told me, he will put a world record, but I was very confident. He told me he was going to cross the fast lap, 49. So he told me to cross 50 so that I can be in medal bracket. Yeah.
And at just 17, how special have these Olympic Games been for you?
Yeah, it's very good for me because this is my first year running international races like this, and I put in my record. So this will give me a morale in my life.
The women's javelin final was an event dominated by one athlete. But that's nothing unusual when the athlete is Barbara Spotikova. The world record holder, former world champion and defending Olympic champion, threw down the gauntlet with her first throw of 66.9 metres. The South African Sunet Viljoen signalled her intentions with her opening effort of 64.53 metres, putting her in early contention for a medal. And Christina Obergfall of Germany also started strongly, beginning with a throw of 65.16 to land in second place. But that would be the only legal throw for her on the night. Most throwers found it hard to better their opening round efforts. But another German, Linda Stahl, was an exception, climbing up to the bronze medal position with this throw of 64.91 on her fourth attempt. But no one was coming close to Spotikova. The Czech champion's fourth throw of 69.55 was her longest. And all four of her legal attempts travelled further than the best anyone else could produce. So a second successive javelin gold medal was assured for Barbara Spotikova of the Czech Republic on a night to remember at London's Olympic Stadium.
Well, I didn't even dare to think about it before that competition, because it's always not good when you think about things that might happen. But I think I didn't realize it. It will come tomorrow. But you know, my coach has been 3 times Olympic champion, so I still have something to do. But I think it's a really big thing, because it didn't happen to any of the Czech women athletes. So I think amazing.
And how much hard work has it taken to stay at the top?
Well, you know, I'm 31 years old, so it's been already a few years I've been working out. So I said to myself this evening, you know, I've gathered so much experience. I'm healthy 100%. I did this year very good training with no health problems. So I have to just go into it, and it must be me, and it happened. So I believe in myself very much this evening, very much.
I really thought that the other girls were so really far, and I just wanted to do a good competition, and now it wasn't that good in the end result, but it's a silver medal, and that's fantastic.
Why do you say that? You have another Olympic medal.
yeah, that's unbelievable, really. And now it's silver, and yeah, I can't believe it.
What would you say about the whole experience here in London at these Olympic Games? What's it been like for you?
Yeah, it was fantastic. I've never had such specific Olympic Games. When you come into the stadium, there's such a great atmosphere, and it's really I got goosebumps all over when I get in, and this was not the same in Beijing, and it was not the same in Athens. It's here in London, and that's probably why I got the silver medal, I don't know.
And how proud will you be to go home and see your family and friends and show them what you've done?
So my family, my parents are here, and my best friends are here, and so yeah, I will have a great party tonight.
I expected the first three girls to throw at least 68, 69 meters, one of them. It didn't happen, so it was my chance, but I didn't use it. But with 64, I'm satisfied, and the bronze medal is, now it's the best day of my life so far.
Could you have won a silver or a gold? Could you have done anything differently?
Of course, everybody could have done something differently, but I was so nervous at the end of the competition, so everything is fine.
Heading into the last two events of the decathlon for 2012, it was Ashton Eaton of the United States who had led all the way, with his US teammate Trey Hardy within striking distance in second place and a tight contest for third. So to the javelin, and Eaton threw a personal best of 61.96 metres with his third attempt to stay in top place. The highlight of this discipline was provided by Leonel Suarez of Cuba, whose throw of 76.94 with his first attempt was the best ever in an Olympic decathlon. That moved Suarez from eighth to third overall, and ultimately the bronze medal. And Trey Hardy of the USA produced a season's best throw of 66.65 metres to keep him in second place heading into the final event. So with only the 1,500 metres remaining, the world record holder Eaton was still within reach of the Olympic record score, but unless disaster struck, probably out of reach of his nearest challenger. With tiredness beginning to show after leading throughout the competition, he finished the race in a little over 4 minutes 30 seconds, well outside his personal best, but easily enough to clinch his first Olympic title. The 2011 world champion Trey Hardy finished second overall, 198 points behind his US teammate, with Cuba's Suarez another 148 points back in third.
It's sunk into my muscles. I'm a little tired, but I feel very, very happy and good.
Yesterday you told us you wanted to be first, you were first. How does it feel now?
It's hard to describe. I feel really good though. I do so much work, and you know, I was able to do it.
How much work? How many sacrifices?
There's a lot of sacrifices. I don't have as much fun as I'd like to with my friends. I don't see my family that much because I'm training. And there's a lot of things that the 24-year-old does that I don't do just because I want to win.
10 months ago, I didn't know I'd be here. I didn't know I'd be training for anything. So this was the most challenging year of my career, and this was the performance that was earned every day over the past year.
Could you have pushed any harder to probably have got a gold here?
You know, it's not a matter of pushing harder or wanting it more or anything like that. You know, things fall where they fall, and we did. I can't look back and say I could have done anything different or worked any harder.
It was a very difficult event. Everybody was well prepared. The North American was very well prepared, and to win him, to beat him, he would have to break a world record. But he prepared himself, and it was a difficult competition.
What would be your message to people back home?
He would like to send the best message to his Cuban people, that always the Cuban, they give the best they have in every competition, and he feels very happy for his victory today.
The final event at what has been described as one of the most impressive venues at these Olympic Games, Horse Guards Parade in London. The gold medal match in men's beach volleyball. The German pair of Brink and Reckerman taking on Emmanuel and Allison of Brazil. The Brazilians are world champions in this sport and were the favorites here. In the first set at 16-all, the Brazilians found themselves in trouble. Emmanuel, the 39-year-old, showing some acrobatic moves, but they couldn't salvage the point. The Brazilians then got up 20-19 and had two set point opportunities. Both were denied by the Germans, who took over the lead and were able to put it home, shocking the Brazilians with their reversal in fortunes. Second set, Brazil started doing what they have done so well for so long. They took a commanding lead, 19-12, but then gave up three straight points and at 19-15 took a timeout to refocus. The Germans making their own missteps after the timeout with a serve that went long to give the Brazilians the 20-15 lead, and then a loose serve that goes wide on second set point. The two teams were now tied at a set apiece in the gold medal match. In the deciding set, the Germans up 6-5 seized the opportunity to go up by 2 points. They had the Brazilians on the run on this point, and that pattern would continue through the tiebreaker. As the Germans continued to score ahead of the Brazilians, taking the tally to 14-11 and match point. But the finish was not to be easy against the Brazilians. Three times they denied match point, with Emmanuel serving an ace to take it to 14-14. But again, Germany would earn the next point, and this time the gold medal point would not be denied, though it would be controversial. The Brazilians continued to argue that the ball was in fact in long after the German celebration had begun. Germany shocking the Brazilians in the gold medal match, the first time since beach volleyball was introduced to the Olympic Games in 1996 that the winner has come from other than the USA or Brazil. The victory ceremony for men's beach volleyball at Horse Guards Parade. The bronze medal went to Plavins and Smedens of Latvia, who defeated the pair from the Netherlands in the bronze medal match. The silver to Brazilians Allison and Emmanuel, who lost in the gold medal match to the German pair of Brink and Reckermann, who took home their first Olympic gold.
It's the biggest goal, the biggest achievement in the sport, and it's amazing, it's fantastic. But right now, I just cannot believe that we really took gold here, so I cannot tell you.
What went through your mind when you saw your flag raised and you heard your national anthem?
Not much, because I was really focused on singing our anthem the right way and finding the right words, because I was so impressed about that moment. And it's just, I mean, there's not much in your mind in that moment. I just feel that everything is a little bit more relaxing now, but that's the best thing about winning. It stays in your body and in your mind for a long time. If you lose, it's right away. It's pretty hard to feel that.
It means a lot, especially because this Olympic Games here in London was the most beautiful and successful, I think, from the other events, from the other Olympic Games. I think the beach volleyball has the high level ever. I think all the best teams were here in these 2 weeks. Unfortunately, we didn't receive the gold medal, but I think the final was unbelievable, was a great exhibition. I think we are teams, we like to win, but sometimes we need to step down and say it was a great game and they deserve to win.
How does this game rank in your career?
Oh, it means a lot. In my fifth tournament, my fifth Olympic Games, play with Alisson. He gave everything for me, the motivation, the energy, the everything that I need to be here. I'm 39 years old and he supports me a lot. I'm very happy, and I think I'll never forget this.